AWS WAF now supports evaluating multiple headers in the HTTP request without the need to specify each header individually in the AWS WAF rules. You can also use this new feature to inspect all cookies in the HTTP request without the need to specify each cookie in the WAF rules. This capability helps you protect your applications or API endpoints from attacks that try to exploit a custom header or cookie or a common header for which you may not have created a WAF rule. You can also limit the scope of inspection to only included or excluded headers and inspect only the keys or only the values for the headers or cookies you want to inspect. For HTTP requests that may include more headers than WAF can inspect, you can provide oversize handling instructions when you define your rule statement. Oversize handling tells WAF what to do with a web request when the number or size of request headers is over the limits. With oversize handling, you can choose whether to continue inspection or skip inspection and mark the request as matching or not matching the WAF rule. There is no additional cost for matching against all headers or cookie details, but standard service charges for AWS WAF still apply. These features are available in all AWS WAF regions and for each supported service, including Amazon CloudFront, Application Load Balancer, Amazon API Gateway, and AWS AppSync. For a full list of request component options that are supported, see the AWS WAF Developer Guide. Attacks may look different than inspected, and they don't always succeed. Often, threat actors are guessing how to compromise a request. Requests should be considered malicious if there is malicious content in the header or cookies, even if the attack fails. When making custom rules in AWS WAF, you can now inspect more than a single header or cookie in a single rule. This allows you to identify a threat even if you don't know exactly what you're looking for. Because there are limits on the size or the numbers of headers or cookies, AWS WAF provides rule choices on how to handle a request if the content exceeds the limit thresholds. Now we're going to look at this new feature in action. In the demo, we will send requests to a live system. You will see how to configure new rules in AWS WAF to block the requests when they contain objectionable header content. First, let's have a look at the system architecture. Here we have an application load balancer configured to route requests to a Lambda function. For demonstration purposes, the Lambda function will simply respond back to the requesting application with the header set in the request. This will allow us to show when a request was successfully routed and see the content of the header sent. AWS WAF will inspect the request before routing. Any request blocked will send an error response back to the requesting application. For the beginning of the demonstration, we will send through a request with several headers containing SQL. SQL code in headers are indicators of a malicious request. I'll also include an identifiable body so that we can see that the data sent is the data returned. Because there are no WAF rules in place, you can see that the request went through and the Lambda function sent back the contents, including all the headers. Note that several headers are guesses at possible server-side variables where MySQL injection could be executed. As you can see, I have many versions of possible user ID fields, some passwords, and item IDs. Now let's look at the WAF console. For this demo, I have a web ACL attached to my ALB. But there are no rules. Let's go ahead and create a rule that will block any SQL showing up in the request headers. First, we'll click on Add Rules, then we'll select Add My Own Rules and Rule Groups. This is the Add Rule form. This makes it easy to create your own custom rule to block the kinds of headers we just saw. First, we'll add a name. Then we'll tell AWS WAF what to inspect. You can see we have many options, but we want to inspect all headers. We have the option here to inspect all parts of the header, or we can specify to look at just the key or just the value. In the content to inspect section, You can choose to allow WAF to inspect all headers or just a subset. For this demo, we'll go ahead and look at them all. For match type, we want to match on any header that contains SQL injection. Oversize handling is where we would tell WAF what to do with the requests that exceed the size or count limits. We can choose to inspect just what's within its limits, or we can declare the request a match or not a match. For now, we're going to select Continue. The rule will inspect what it can, ignoring any content outside the size limits. The Then section tells WAF what to do in case of a rule match. We will leave the action as block. In the custom response, I want to specify a 403 response code. For this demo, I will also return a custom body. This is not always necessary, but for the demo, it will give us an easy indicator that the rule is working as expected. Now that we're done, we'll go ahead and click Add Rule. On this page, we set the rule priority. Since it is the only rule, we can go ahead and just hit save. Now that the rule is applied, we can go back to our demo application and see the results. Now back to the application. We will send the request again. I'll change the request body so that we can see that the data sent is the data returned. The rule worked. It correctly identified the SQL code in the headers and returned our custom body. But what about an oversized request? I'll add 200 headers to push the malicious headers to the bottom of the list. With the current rule, the malicious headers will be invisible, so when we execute this request, the SQL code escapes detection. As you can see, the rule failed to block this request because the number of headers was too large and the malicious headers weren't matched to the rule. So let's go back to the AWS WAF console. To change our rule, we're going to select it and then click Edit. Now back in the rule editor, we'll scroll down to the Oversize Handling section and change the selection. We're going to select Match because for this application, any request with more than 200 headers would be trying to hide malicious content. Now we'll save. And save. And now we'll go back to the application and see how that works. With our rule now changed to assume a match if the number of headers exceeds the limit, we'll execute the request again with the 200 extra headers. And now the request has been blocked. When making your own rules, you will have to assess what kind of oversize handling would be best for your application. To learn more about multi-header and multi-cookie handling in AWS WAF, visit the developer guide and the feature announcement. Both of these links can be found in the description of this video. Thank you for taking the time to watch. If this content was helpful, please click the like icon. Have a great day.